The retail resurgence hitting major roadblocks this week, with several big retailer shares plunging on the back of results. What happened? Something changing fundamentally, just as the biggest year of the year is now 2 days away. Courtney Reagan joins us now with more. Courtney, what is happening here?
Hey, Andrew. Yeah, so this week's retail reports really seem to be like a 180 from last week's, but I think there could be some opportunity in the wreckage. So Best Buy reported a strong quarter in many aspects, but like other retailers, margins were compressed from higher costs related to labor, supply chain, even organized retail crime. While inventory is up year over year, CEO Corey Barry acknowledged some product availability issues with the ongoing supply chain congestion in some categories. And there's worry about waning demand for consumer electronics broadly. Shares fell 12% on the back of those results. Dick's Sporting Goods shares also lost 4%, even after posting a really strong quarter with comparable sales 6 times stronger than forecast and upbeat expectations about the holiday quarter. D.A. Davidson points out that Best Buy, along with Dick's Sporting Goods, historically are among the worst performers in the firm's retail coverage this time of the year through year end. But the firm says Best Buy usually outperforms starting in February, so it recommends a buy on the weakness. Nordstrom and Gap reported pretty ugly quarters, both hit by significantly higher cost of labor and suffered supply chain issues. Neither are unique issues, though, right now, but also neither managed as well as competitors did. After hours, Nordstrom shares plunged 23%, Gap lost 16%. Gap said despite its mitigation efforts, it didn't have enough merchandise to satisfy shopper demand. Nordstrom felt that too in certain categories, and its rack business suffered from a lack of inventory because less of it is flowing to the off-price arm when those same brands are selling at full price. If you think Gap and Nordstrom management can course correct in time to take advantage of this strong consumer environment, then consider the sell-off a promotional price. Becky?
Excellent analysis, Courtney.